Because if we don't win on November 5th, I think our country is going to cease to exist. It could be the last election we ever have. I actually mean that. We don't win. I think this could be the last election we ever have. That's where our country is going.
Is that like a prediction? Is that a threat? I mean, he's not like in his high energy mode, but he loves throwing around threats of violence and chaos. So I can't rule it out. Is it a stupid thing to say? Sure, yeah. The idea that the stakes of the election are that if Biden wins, that's it for elections. It's a claim that's kind of undercut by the fact that Biden is president now and we're gonna have an election. Also, you guys don't even think that Biden is gonna be alive in a couple years. How exactly is he gonna maintain a stranglehold on America if he's dead? It doesn't make any sense.
Before we continue with the story, we depend on members to keep on going. Don't wait, click join now on YouTube.
This is what they do. They pose unique, never before seen in American history threats to a variety of the different norms and systems that make up our culture, our society, our government. And then after doing that and being criticized for it, they then turn around and say, no, it's actually you guys that do it. See, it's an even playing ground, an even battlefield, but it's not. There is a threat potentially to democracy, but it ain't from Joe Biden winning. It isn't even just from Donald Trump winning. Potentially Donald Trump losing could pose a graver immediate threat to democracy. I will refer you to the results of the 2020 election. But in any event, he does have, I guess, sort of an ace up his sleeve that he's gonna tie into the debunked BS conspiracy theories around Easter that Fox has been spreading all week in this clip.
Such total disrespect to Christians, and November 5th is going to be called something else. You know what it's going to be called? Christian Visibility Day, when Christians turn out in numbers that nobody has ever seen before.
Yeah, so yeah, they love that man in that crowd. Christian Visibility Day, yeah. Because generally you don't see Christian stuff in America. There's like no acknowledgement of Christians. I honestly can't tell you the last time I saw a Christian. I'm pretty sure that in LA, all of their iconography has been banned by Gavin Newsom. But they love that stuff. They love the idea that they should be in charge of everything. Also, they've always historically been in charge of everything. They say, and also largely it's kind of true. But they're also victims. And they need Christian Visibility Day because they've been like pushed into the shadows by society, but they're the strongest, most vigorous political movement. It's a confused mess, Sharon, but what do you make of it?
I was just drifting and watching in that clip the people behind him and wondering, first of all, why no one says to him, what do you mean by that when he says, you know, there'll never be another election? What exactly do you mean by that? But that would be silly to go down that rabbit hole. It's a farce. And I don't think when you're dealing with a narcissist, you can even peel back the many layers. You know, it's just that question of, are you going to put your hand on that leather Bible that you're selling for $60 if you win? And just, you got to leave it at that. I don't know how to handle this. I don't know how to handle the people who actually read the Bible. And if you believe, you believe, I guess. And then turn around and worship this guy. They are worshiping him. There's no getting around it.
100%. And the weird aspect of that, and I won't go at length because I know we talk about this constantly, but that like there are true believer Republican candidates who actually believe all of the crazy stuff that they say they believe about Christianity, whether it has any basis in the Bible or anything, whatever. They don't know or care, but they believe it. But Trump doesn't. And they pick the false idol over the true believers. And then worship him more than they agree with those who actually worship the same God as them and believe the nonsense that they've said. I will remind everyone, maybe we'll play it on tomorrow's show. There's a video going around of the Lord's Prayer being said at a thing where Trump is, and he's trying to like mouth along to it. He doesn't know what he's talking about. And by the way, if you don't know the Lord's Prayer, that's fine. I don't know that I could get it right. I'm an atheist though. And the thing about Trump is, so's he. That's why he can't get it right. But again, they'll never see it. They'll never acknowledge it. And in the meantime, maybe he's just a useful tool. I mean, if he gives them the Christian supremacist state, the white Christian supremacist state that they want, maybe it doesn't matter if he believes that all of this is made up.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.